Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Punk Rock Horror Podcast, day two of Colorado Festival of Horror. I am back on the show floor with the amazing Zach Eastman behind the camera, helping getting some coverage of what you might be missing out on. Today, I'm talking with the fantastic Kevin, and Kevin's going to tell us about what he has been promoting and why he's here at this convention. How's it going, Kevin?
It's going very well, thank you.
So, to let all the ghouls, gals, and creeps and mutants at Horrorland at home know, what do you do and what is your art?
Sure. I am a publisher, an indie comic book publisher. I specialize in both black and white magazines, the old school horror type magazine. I have a full line series of things. I have children's comics, a little something for everybody. I like to say I have there's a family friendly line, my best selling Lady Frankenstein, my Monster Smash-Ups, my Fractured Scary Tales. And then I also have some books and things I sell for people that don't like comics. But I'm primarily interested, my primary focus is on comic books at this convention.
Yeah, I mean, just staring right at the table, which all of our listeners can see right on the video as well, you have a lot of beautiful comic books that are just standing out. And I already said it to you, but I'll say it again. The more I stare at it, the more it does pop out. You did mention that you don't do any of the art, but you instead license people to do the art for you.
Right. Well, I hire people to do it, yeah. So I have, this here, my Supered Up Monster Kids is my family-friendly line. There aren't a lot of monster books specific to kids, and this is my version of kind of Teen Titans. There's a Zomboy, Draculad, Frankenstein, and Mummy's Girl, four ordinary kids that get the powers of their favorite monsters. I'm up to issue 8 of that, working on 9 right now. The Fractured Scary Tales is how I started the comics. They're all parodies of movies and TV shows. So instead of things like The Good, the Bad, the Ugly, you get Good, the Bad, the Undead, Planet of the Were-Apes, Maltese Frankenstein. My Christmas one's been popular at this particular con. This one has Rudolph the Rabid Reindeer, Frosty the Snow Maniac. It's a wonderful on life. They're all meant to make you chuckle. They're all very tongue-in-cheek, or I like to say tongue-in-shriek. Makes a great stocking stuffer if you're looking for something for somebody for Christmas. They're all standalone, 7 stories, 40 pages, not 40 page long, but 40 page magazine, 7 stories. And every story is a different artist, so you get a different look. So if you just thumb through, you see all different kinds of styles of stories, just like the classic monster magazines of yesterday. For people that don't like humor with their horror, there's my Monster Smash-Ups, which is more serious monsters. There's a Dracula story, a Frankenstein story, a mummy story. Again, multiple stories, 40-page magazine, black and white, and they all have a twist ending. My latest one is my new LGBT monster book, which is a gender swap on classic monsters. There's instead of the Bride of Frankenstein, it's the Groom of Frankenstein, the She-Wolf of Paris instead of the Werewolf of London, all kinds of gender swap roles and classic monsters. My pride and joy is my Lady Frankenstein. This one is based on a screenplay I wrote, which was optioned a couple times but never made into a movie. So I'm now serializing it into a 6-part miniseries. I've got the first 4 issues done, almost done with issue 5. This one is kind of a throwback to the classic monster magazines of yesterday, too. I actually printed on this age newsprint, so you get a real retro feeling. The art is very kind of monochromatic, although it's colorized, but it has a more simple palette, so it kind of feels very retro. I'm very proud. It's a mashup of Frankenstein and Mummy with a female doctor who gets hired by this consortium in Egypt to transplant the brain of an ancient mummy, and of course nothing good happens from that. But for people that don't like comics, I do have my award-winning play. This is a trial of the Frankenstein monster. It's called The People Versus Frankenstein. I've won quite a few awards. This is only a handful of the ones I've won. I just couldn't keep printing it every time I got a new award. But I'm very, very proud of it. It's a stage play written, so it's not like a regular book. And for people that don't like to read, well, I brought some copies of Singenor, which was a movie I was in the 80s. I used to, before I made comics, I was a film producer and an actor, and some of the, one of the projects I worked on was as a rubber-suited monster in this movie, Singenor. My biggest claim to fame was producing a movie called Dinosaur Valley Girls, so with Karen Black, which played on USA Cable for a number of years. And that's my short spiel. I kind of just went hog wild, but maybe you got some other.
We love that. We love the fact that there's so much passion and love for horror in general. And I think one of the coolest things about it is that very much so horror is encouraged for creators to take their own spin on it. And you've definitely done that. I mean, whether it is making horror comic books for kids, you know, to have their own type of Teen Titans to look up to, or, you know, putting a twist and gender swapping on some of them. I think it's so creative and awesome what you're doing. Well, and I'm really glad that we've gotten to talk to you more about it. Also, I mean, the Peele versus Frankenstein and having all those awards, seriously, man, like, you are so humble. And I think that's really cool. I'd be so braggy about it all the time.
Well, thank you. I just try to be humble. You know, I've been writing for many, many years, and it's just nice to get some recognition for something. I've got a graphic novel coming out in a couple months that I'm hoping, it's based on another screenplay that I wrote that has won some awards, and so I'm hoping when that novel comes out, it'll be an award winner too. And I should point out my website, fracturedscarytales.com. Everything you see here, you can get online. So it's Fractured Scary Tales. Some people want to say Fractured Fairy Tales because that's what's kind of a play on, but it's scary tales.
So for the Ghouls, Gals, Creeps, and Mutants, they can go online to support you if they can't come physically and buy your stuff. Is there any other way they can follow you or support you?
I do have Facebook, but I'm really like a social media. I'm really, really bad at that. I've got to get better on it. Everybody says everything would, my sales would triple if I just, you know, get on the computer now and then. But I'm really old school about it, and I don't understand why people want to see what's going on. But they can go to my website and usually list the conventions. Though because of COVID last year, I didn't update it for this year. But I will be back in the Denver area for those people next month for the Fan Expo in Halloween at downtown Colorado here.
Beautiful. Thank you so much, Kevin, for hanging out with me and talking to the Ghouls, Gals, Creeps, and Mutants. Is there any last words you want to give to them before we part ways?
I'm glad people love monsters. I get a lot of compliments about my vest because I'm a big
vest.
Monster fan. So it's nice to see a whole new generation of people that still embrace not only the classics but the new genres of horror as well.
Awesome. Thank you, Kevin, for hanging out with us. I appreciate it.
No problem. Come on!